They don't care.
Right.
And the money doesn't exist. The money doesn't, this is why they printing it all. Cause here's the thing. Have you ever looked in your bank account? I mean, I know you got a lot of money, but you still must just enjoy hearing the fucking balance from time to time on something.
No, nowadays it just makes me nervous.
Just because I've gone into my account. I'm not at a place where I go not into my account.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes there might be a dollar missing or 10. I go, I know that I had something, 10.
Ten.
And I got something, four. Not 10, 4.
It's like, what?
So I'm like, somebody just took something. Because I swear to God, I paid for a coffee once. It was $2. I paid with a credit card. We don't have, money's useless right now. So once all the money is just garbage and we're paying, they could just take it. They don't need to come and send the army to take your shit. They just take your shit, pay back somebody. That see, this is where we talk about race a lot on this show and shit, man. I love talking about race because I think this shit is fun.
Yeah.
I think it's fun not liking other motherfuckers for what they do.
Exactly.
But at the end of the day, I don't have any hatred because I know it's a scam to get my... I used to hate the militia guys in the hills.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they paint them to me as a black man, crazy motherfuckers who are out to kill me. That's their point.
KKK
they're practicing to kill me.
Yeah.
Those guys are practicing for the government because they don't want to fucking pay taxes. They're well read about the fucking the Constitution.
Mm-hmm.
When they go, the Second Amendment, guns, we no guns. To me, if you're not educated to some degree,
yeah,
you go, why the fuck do these crazy goddamn crackers need guns? All they gonna do is come kill me. What the fuck? I fuck that. Get them. But now I know. Once you learn, oh shit, it's to protect you from what's going on right fucking now. Cops are out of hand. I mean, look, there's some, as a, where I grew up, a cop is a cop because he got his uniform on. We didn't give a fuck about a cop. Cop was the enemy. As I get older, own property, meet police.
Yes, exactly.
And humanize them, right?
Mm-hmm.
I go, damn, I don't just say, oh, fuck a cop, but there are cops who think they're the police because they're the police. They not the law. There used to be things you could say, like, hey, man, you can't just do that to me, cop. They have a thing called disorderly conduct, which erases all your horse shit that you think you know about the law. It's essentially to say, I can do anything I fucking want to you.
Oh, you can be
anytime.
Brought in for anything.
Anytime.
Yeah, anytime. Disorderly
Don't
conduct.
Don't question authority.
Disorderly conduct is that one of those things where it's like, I didn't like what you just said
yes.
to me.
Yes. And here's the problem. Fuck all the top people. It's us doing it to each. We just say yes.
I will
fuck other people.
Yeah, we're at the bottom of the little marionette strings. You know?
We just go yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
So what?
Guy and I fucking African, quote unquote, tries to blow up a plane. This inept little douchebag.
With his underwear
African,
bomb.
With his underwear bomb to get us to submit. To showing my non-big dick in an X-ray?
No, now we gotta all show our penises.
My funny hanging balls? Some cunt? Some fat bitch from Newark? She gets to see my balls hang? And she gets level 12 clearance? It's bullshit!
I'm gonna make my balls very gamey. For now on, when I have to fly.
Just so they could see a fungus.
Yeah, just very good.
Let something grow to it becomes explosive material.
But Patrice, you're going off on a lot of different tangents.
Not
here,
really.
Which is
but
fine.
It's the same.
Not really.
But bring it back to the guy who crashed his plane down
it's
there in Austin.
It's all the same.
Yeah, that's
he
what I'm getting
that
at.
For that. He feels like he'd rather die.
And why doesn't the mainstream media, because when we say the media, people go, you're the media. Why doesn't the mainstream media pick up on some of these points? And why do they just go for the easy out and just go, well, another fucking kook decided to blah, blah.
Because they're the TSA. They're the National Guard who, if they're told to come and lock down a community.
Yeah.
Or they're the guys in the movies with the helmets on that say you got the outbreak monkey shit. The news are just they're told what to fucking do, and they do it.
Listen, and going with that point, we have 8 TVs in the studio right now. We have a guy that flew a plane into a building yesterday because he's a bit disgruntled, and some say he's just a crazy man, whatever. But it certainly should open up a discussion. But instead, I'm watching the TVs around our studio set up for the big Tiger Woods press conference today.
Look, there's a guy. He's live.
He's a local guy. He has to be there for the big Tiger Woods press conference today, which is a nothing press conference that's going to last less than 5 minutes. It means fucking nothing to just about every single person that's going to watch this horseshit on TV today.
And have an open dialogue on this. They don't want that.
I'll tell you what they'll do. They'll fucking shake Haiti again before they let this motherfucker. They'll figure out how to make Haiti hit another earthquake so we can sing songs so that this motherfucker looks like a lone kook that you don't talk about. But this motherfucker killed himself.
Reading his fucking letter, dude, you understand his frustration.
But look at this. They're discussing. Maybe I can pop
They're
it
discussing
out
Tiger.
Yeah, you know, you think about that, and I think David Faraday, the golf analyst, said he wouldn't be surprised if he sees Tiger take the whole year off.
Wow, really?
People think he's going to go back to rehab. And then... the feeling
guy
is
killed
he's
himself.
Probably going to play in the Bay,
plane.
You know, the Arnold Palmer event, which is just outside of his house.
This is what they need to discuss.
They're discussing it in a serious manner, like they should be discussing the guy that just flew a plane into a building. This is David Blaine waving his hand over to the left while he does something over here on the right.
I mean, it's just because
this is what they're discussing today. I've barely seen coverage on the plane crash. Barely.
That's a story from outside here. Let's send it back to you in the next hour.
Thank you, Duke. All right, you can see Tiger's comments right here on Fox News this morning at 11
thank
o'clock.
Well, thank you.
Also yeah, about an open discussion about taxes and the government and why an individual would do something like this instead of just writing it off as a manifesto, a wandering, crazy diatribe. How about you just openly discuss it?
Mm-hmm.
I like what Patrice said about we are more fucked now than we were when we left England.
When this country was created.
When it was a colony, and England said, send your shit. You could live there, mm-hmm. but send all your shit over to us. All the riches and good shit, because you belong to us still. And then the Patriots said, you know something? I like this place. Fuck the king. Fuck this shit. This is now us. We live here. And then England goes, hey, no, fuck you. We're yours. All right? War. Now we're going to fight you. To keep this shit. It's worse now than it was then. Yep. They're asking for a lot more.
Yep.
Even in, you know, now dollars and shit like that. I always liked the quote, the Tree of Liberty must be refreshed from time to time with the blood of patriots and tyrants. You would never hear a politician say that. Are you willing to take a bullet, though? I am much too important on the LIE. I am
that's
much
what I'm saying.
Too important. I know exactly.
Are you willing to get smoked
that's
for
saying,
your belief?
Though, that's that quote is Thomas Jefferson, who is looked at as, you know, the fucking patriot, national hero, fucking founding father. But he said shit like that if you said it now, you're locked the fuck up as some kooky militant militia guy.
And here's the thing. If you look at the Constitution,
mm-hmm.
they put things... And in order
of importance.
Of importance to keep England from fucking you in your asshole.
They didn't say in no particular order.
First thing, the news.
Yeah.
Meaning what you just said, why is this douchebag talking about Tiger when this
should
guy
be talking about something a little more serious?
Thinking he did a revolutionary act to please everybody. Listen.
Right.
The freedom of press. The mm-hmm. freedom for people to go, no, this is some fucked up shit going on, but the press isn't free. Fox is, you know, they own news. CNN owns news. This shit is, so the second thing is guns.
Right.
They thought that the people should have pistols.
Number two with a bullet, guns.
Number two.
Number two.
Number thriller. The thriller of Constitution. No. The Eagles. The Eagles' best greatest hits album. Number one. That the Eagles of the Constitution was the press should be able to say anything they fucking want. They expose this bullshit. Number two.
Speak
in case
your mind without persecution.
Thriller was fucking. And then I don't even know what AC/DC Black.
I think that's one of those wacky. You shall not be able to take a soldier and put him in your house and board him during some type of war or peace time.
There's a term called posse comitatus. You know, you just be on there. One thing leads to another. Posse comitatus, right? Mm-hmm. It's a law, supposedly. You know, they made it. The army can't do civilian police work.
Right.
If you see an army in your neighborhood, a motherfucker with army shit, that's illegal. The government is not supposed to be sending the fucking army to do shit in your neighborhood. It's standing army where you live. It's illegal. But whatever. But that's what we are. Hey, what are you going to do? They want what they want. $2 million. Hey, stop complaining.
Stop complaining.
I play my tides. You douches.
The guy doesn't even understand. I understand you paid over $2 million in taxes last year. Were you happy?
Let's say hi to Tim in Portland.
Hey, Tim.
Tim,
were you happy paying over $2 million in taxes? And what percentage of what you make is $2 million?
You know, honestly, I got to set this up the right way and say that I used to be a poor black kid in the Bronx, and I grew up and I got into microprocessing. And, you know, so I always dreamed about being rich, and now that I am, it really doesn't. I just look at it this way. The government is the biggest mafia in the world, and you got to pay to play.
Got to pay to play.
And you're okay with that?
No, I'm not okay with it, but I believe that the asshole who killed himself would have killed himself for another reason. He was nuts. It had nothing to do with taxes.
Well, when is enough going to be enough, though? That's the question today. The question today as they continue to take more and more of your money, and you do feel out there something is going on, something's bubbling. And what is that going to lead? Is that going to lead to anything? Maybe it never leads to anything. I don't know.
And when will you feel
when will you feel it? Yeah. Right.
Well, honestly, I always feel like something's bubbling because I'm a black guy, but I mean, honestly, I'm always afraid of people. So the idea of a bunch of people getting together with this fervor, I mean, first they're pissed off about the taxes, then they're coming for my ass.
And it's a big plan too, brother, because listen, everybody, it's like everything in this world, right? This is a lottery. We gotta have some people hit a lottery so everybody can think that they can win.
Right, right.
So when you have a bootstrap story like you picked yourself up from the Bronx, we have to hear these kind of stories to make people who might fly a plane into a building for some reason
go, maybe tomorrow.
Yeah, right. Go,
maybe
hey,
tomorrow's
this
my
guy's
day.
An asshole.
Where I get to make my money.
Because I did it. But right. It's not, this is a system, man, that's based on, like a lot of women don't understand, right? The women's liberation mm-hmm. movement. They think it was based on, hey, we're tired. This wrong to just continue to fuck women on every level. No, it's because these bitches was home raising the kids. And they wasn't getting taxed. They didn't make no motherfucking money. So get these bitches riled up so they can go out there and make some money so we can take that shit because we owe.
Half the population isn't paying taxes.
Hold on a minute.
Get them out there working.
Hold on a minute.
Probably going to look down if he's really feeling emotional.
Do you think he should read from a statement or do you think he should just say it from his heart?
Reading from a statement is the worst thing. You come across as unemotional.
It's just Tiger Woods. Tiger Woods.
So what you want to do, you want to make
very disillusioned.
With someone on specific points and then
now they're doing body language. They got body language
he's
experts.
He's going to be doing some self-touching, pacification, making himself feel
pacification
better.
Really
look for genuine remorse.
What is he going to suck on the nipple of a hooker?
Yeah.
Let's look at some of the past mea culpas that we've had in our news. The first one is our former
slide of hand
Elliot
right
Spitzer
there.
He apologized.
There's some slide of hand you're saying. You're seeing magic tricks.
To every New Yorker.
And I guarantee if you find something that's talking about the IRS guy, he's just a mental case.
Whoa.
And that's what he is.
Patrice, ATV's on. Every once in a while I see the shot of the building on fire, but I don't see them sitting down with experts.
They're not discussing,
Or anybody. I'm sure they did a little discussing on Fox News last night.
But not in
CNN and MSNBC, but...
Not on a level of what was affecting him that he did this. They don't delve into it. Like
so
I said,
just broad strokes,
six pages that this guy wrote that was pretty concise and understandable. It wasn't a rambling diatribe. I understood everything that was written there. It wasn't like, my dog was talking to me. Satan told me to do this. Fucking, you know, it made sense. It was his story from the time he was in high school till the time he said, goodbye, I'm fucking crashing my plane into a building. All in between was his life and how
disgusted he was at American people for just being sheep, and how he bought into it, and then how disillusioned he got when time and time again he just got fucked in the ass.
What?
And then it's like, I had no problem understanding what he was writing.
Why?
I'm not flying a plane into a fucking building, right. But I understood his writings.
They basically label us as shock jocks. Why are we talking about this way more than any fucking news reader
today? This is shocking.
It's unbelievable. I mean,
because they don't want to.
A-Rod.
Yeah.
Also
A-Rod. Throw A-Rod in.
It had to do with steroids.
My cousin started telling.
The White House also said, and they put this out so quickly, this is not a terrorist event. This, don't worry, it's not terrorism. Now, hold on.
I see Patrice.
Here is a guy.
I see what you're doing over there.
That is disgruntled.
Whoa, slow down a little bit.
With the United States government and decided to take violent action against the government because of his hatred, disillusionment, disenchantment, whatever. He is a terrorist.
But you know...
I'm not saying...
But the reason they're not is because, you know, they call it Big Sis now. They're not Big Brother.
Right.
If people are not... You know, they used to call it Big Brother. Now it's Big Sis because there's a woman that runs the show. She made priority one in terms of terrorism acts, but no one's talking about it. It's just in there. Are the crazy crackers in the hills?
Yeah.
Number one priority for the safety of this country are the crazy, the quote unquote, because I'm saying quote unquote because I'm not buying into it.
Mm-hmm.
Is these guys in the hills who just want to be left alone?
Yeah,
those guys are the next guys. This is perfect for them to muscle. Those dudes, like mm-hmm. Ruby Ridge.
Ruby Ridge, right, yeah.
Not necessarily David.
Waco.
But that was one of those things where they make us go, this is a fucking kook.
Yeah.
But here's the thing. 30 million black folks, right? Okay. Very difficult for me to go, yeah, this guy with his fucking, Crocodile Dundee hat and his, and his fucking cross eye. I'm on his side. See, that's why the racial game has to go on.
Right.
Because if you're going up there fucking with these crazy crackers in the hill who have cults, and we don't apply mind thinking to that, this is all a setup because the government doesn't want us to really be upset.
It's a divide and conquer kind of a thing, too. There's strength in numbers, so the more you can put people into categories and divide them up, the less they're going to get together and band together and go, we're getting fucked here.
That's why everybody, and don't get this twisted, anybody. I do not support us being together.
Yes, me
because
neither.
Because anybody... who has any charisma that could galvanize people to think and come together for common good.
Imagine that.
In history, gets fucking smoked. Starting with Jesus. Gandhi, smoked. Lincoln, free the slaves, smoked.
Yep.
Malcolm X, when he was hating white folks, wonderful life he was living. Mm-hmm. When he went and found out white people were like Muslim like him and he was rethinking it, get your hand on my pocket, nigga. Smoked. Martin Luther King, smoked. Gandhi, smoked.
Yeah.
Fucking Donald Rumsfeld lives a wonderful life.
Anwar Sadat, fucking shaking hands with Menachem Begin.
Smoked. Bringing people together.
What kind of cigarettes?
Nigga.
Fucking lead cigarettes.
Oh.
Fucking Leadies. They call them Leady non-filters.
Dead.
Oh, dead.
Sorry for all the fucking crackers in the hills that I'm trying to relate to. He was murdered.